invaders were raiding South America, conquering empire after empire. However, in the least expected place, a determined and fierce tribe were able to give a fair fight for 300 years. All thanks to an intelligent leader, a warrior that knew the enemy from the inside, and guide his people in a war so epic that even the invaders dedicate the last epic poem to him. Lautaro, the Mapuche Warlord. The Spaniards, on their conquest of America, faced various empires, such as the Aztecs and the Incas, powerful empires, but based on a hierarchical political structure of emperors, kings, and noblemen, that could be overthrown and easily replaced by the conquerors as the new rulers. After founding the city of Santiago, the new capital of Chile, Pedro Gutiérrez de Valdivia, captain of the Spanish forces, began with his troops a journey to the south to conquer the kingdom granted to him by the King of Spain. In his journey, they faced various bellicose and fierce tribes, tribes that lacked a large-scale structure, but in the presence of a common enemy, did not hesitate to join forces. In the Battle of Quilicura, they started a war that they expected, but never dreamed of how long and bloody would it be. In 1545, Valdivia, who was leading the expedition to the south, would fight a new battle against fierce resistance by the Biobío River, known by the natives as Arauco. These natives called themselves Mapuche, men of the land, a semi-sedentary tribe with a social structure based on patriarchs named Loncos. They were various Mapuche tribes, defined by their geographical location, such as the Picunches, the people of the north, which already fought with the Spaniards in Santiago, the Mapuche of the Araucanía, the Lafkenche, people of the coast, the Pehuenche, people of the mountains, and the Huiliche, people of the Great South. The Mapuche were a canoeing society, with a rotary horticulture system, so their villages tended to dissolve and form in various points of a much larger territory, but always near the water streams. The villages consisted of rucas, large houses with various forms, round, oval, also rectangular, structured with firm trunks, and coliwe, a kind of bamboo, with no windows, but only one entry facing the east, where the sun rises, in the interior a fire that never went out, and blackened the walls with soot. This particular village on the Mocha Valley, which Pedro de Valdivia faced, was commanded by the Lonco Curiñancu. The Spaniards had the mission of forming cities and appease the natives, so without much hesitation, began to indoctrinate the inhabitants with the edge of their swords. The village was taken, and as a warning to all the Mapuche who dares to defy the Spanish crown, they cut off the toes of the caitiff Lonco and his warriors. Some children and women were taken to Santiago as prisoners, to work as yanaconas, servants of the Spanish nobility. One of the children, Leftraru, the son of the Lonco Curiñancu, was particularly more willing to learn than the other servants, and won the affection of his masters, being named Felipe Lautaro. Lautaro, in his years of service, was entrusted with the task of caring for the horses, learning to ride them. One of the captains, Marco Veas, not only taught him the Spanish language, but also taught him about European military strategy. Lautaro was so appreciated by the Spaniards that he even became the personal servant of Pedro de Valdivia himself, accompanying him in his campaigns and military exercises. Conquering and founding cities such as the city of Concepción in 1550 and numerous defensive forts such as Purén and Tucapel. From the shadows, he concealed his hatred toward his master, as he never forgot what they did to the people of his village led by his father. One morning, Lautaro managed to escape on a horse at some point in the year 1552. And appeared before the group of Mapuche led by the Lonco Colo Colo. Valdivia, however, did not take into account all that Lautaro had been able to learn in the years he was his servant, and the danger that this could cause to him or his troops, and he did not pursue the boy's escape. At first, the Mapuche distrusted him, but soon Lautaro demonstrated his innate leadership skills. Also, he taught his people not to fear the horse and to know how to ride it, with which the first Mapuche cavalry was created. Lautaro also taught them the use of Spaniard weapons and their combat tactics in the open field, and also the importance of military intelligence, using spies infiltrated as servants in the Spaniard lines. After more than a year instructing different Mapuche warriors about the war tactics of the Castilians, on December 15 of the year 1553, Lautaro appears as the main Mapuche warlord, the Toqui, in the Battle of Tucapel. In this battle, Lautaro and his troops, against all predictions, beat the Spaniards on the open field. Using his spies, he knew about the movement of the Spanish forces and divided them, preparing an ambush for Pedro de Valdivia. Isolated in the smoking ruins in the fort of Tucapel, Valdivia and his troops were surrounded by a numerous and determined foe. Only Valdivia and a cleric managed to escape, but their horses got bogged down in a swamp, which caused Lautaro to finally capture and kill Valdivia. As a consequence of the first important defeat for the Spanish during the Arauco War, the conquistadors, completely demoralized, thought of desisting the conquer of the Araucanía, and would not even try to defend Concepción, retreating to Santiago. Lautaro, leading successive victories, was confident that he could not only expel the Spanish from Arauco, but Chile. He was able to recruit more than 2,000 warriors and resume fighting in the year 1556, crossing the Maule River for the first time to reach Santiago. However, in the course of making alliances with the other tribes, Lautaro became also to gain some enemies. Some more peaceful tribes who did not agree to fight and thought of him as a dictator. The campaigns continued, and Lautaro, knowing the importance of strategic territorial occupation, managed to establish a fort in the Central Valley, from which he tried to control the area and its resources, and thus permanently expel the Spanish from that region. Lautaro replicated what he observed on the Spanish forts, using the terrain in his favor, hindering the cavalry attack, placing the fort on small hills surrounded with palisades and a moat, with many traps around. Knowing the mentality of the Spaniards, this particular fort, the Fort of Pedreroa, was an act of defiance, challenging the Spaniards to a frontal assault. However, the humiliating treatment of Lautaro and his men towards the Picunche, who inhabited the area, earned them the enmity of several leaders who betrayed him, revealing the position of Lautaro to the Spaniards. In a surprise attack, they descended from the hill behind the fortification, led by the treacherous Picunches, who shot the ruca where Lautaro was sleeping. Surrounded by enemies, Lautaro fought to his death. His men continued fighting and were ultimately defeated. Lautaro's head was exhibited in the Plaza de Armas in Santiago a few days after the event, as an example to anybody who dares to defy the Spanish Empire. The death of Lautaro at the young age of 22 did not weaken the determination of the Mapuche people, who continued fighting the following years. Other Toqui's will rise to lead the cause of the resistance against the Spanish occupation, reaching almost a mythical status. Caupolicán, Pelantaro, Galvarino, and many others, who after decades of war managed to destroy all the seven cities of the Spanish in the south, following the victory of Curalaba in 1598.